Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and this is macOS Mojave. I've been using it for 2 weeks on this 2016 13-inch MacBook Pro. This is the top spec one with a 512 gig solid state drive. So this one is pretty fast as far as what it does most of the time, and while I'm on the go, I use it to edit in Final Cut Pro and do all of my on-the-go editing. Now, this particular version is pretty good for an early beta, but still has its bugs. So you'll see we're in the dark mode right now. You can tell at the top here, this bar is dark, and you can easily switch that in system preferences. Now it works, I would say 95% of the time. You can go between light and dark here, but it works pretty well with the exception of certain applications that are not yet updated for it. So maybe I'm in airmail or one of these applications, and sometimes the dark mode just doesn't work right, and I'm sure that will be updated later on. So that's not too big of a deal. But when we're in applications such as Final Cut Pro, this is where I've noticed some differences. So I edit a lot in here. You'll see it brings this up. It's taking a moment, and this is a video I edited last week. So what you'll see here is we can scroll through the timeline, no problem, but what happens when I try to export this is it's really slow. So for example, if I go to the end of this timeline, you'll see it's 3 minutes long, roughly. And this video normally would take me 3 to 5 minutes to fully compress. Now it's taking 40 to 45 minutes to compress this video. The same exact video took that long, so it's not something you really want to use if you're editing regularly. At least that's been my experience. Sometimes you'll get pop-ups saying it's not compatible and that the app needs to be updated. I get that a lot, and if it pops up, I'll show you here. Let's exit this, and you'll see it takes a while to exit. We're just waiting for it. There we go. And applications such as Pixelmator seem to work okay. Now Pixelmator Pro is open. You'll see it looks okay. It works fine. But sometimes I'll get an app compatibility message just like I do in Final Cut Pro, Photos, and the regular Pixelmator. So these are things that need to be updated. It's not a huge deal, but for an early beta, it's pretty stable. We've got our little stacks here, which work really well. And everything else seems to be pretty stable. News is working okay. Let's go open this up. These new apps, you'll see things are a little bit slow, and normally they open much faster when I wasn't on the beta. So there's definitely some optimization that needs to be done there, and we'll see that, I'm sure, with future updates and by the time it's out. So that's really all there is to it. I think it's safe to run if you don't have any production level things to do. If you're not editing videos or photos and you just want to try it out, it's probably pretty safe. But if you just want to use it on your main machine, I would highly advise against that because it may cut into the production time of doing different things, such as Final Cut Pro, for example. I can't speak to Adobe as far as that working, but I'm assuming based off the changes to the architecture using Metal and no longer using OpenGL, that might be what's slowing it down. So let me know if you've had those same compatibility issues with Final Cut Pro or Pixelmator, if any of those issues or those pop-ups coming up. I'd love to hear what you have to say in the comments below. If you'd like to see more of these updates on Mojave as well as iOS that I normally do, let me know if you'd like to see the follow-ups on the betas of Mojave as well. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.